For 31 days now, the Obama administration has been telling us that Americans by the millions are visiting the new health insurance website, despite all of its problems. But no one in the administration has been willing to tell us how many policies have been purchased, and this may be the reason. CBS News has learned enrollments got off to an incredibly slow start. Cheryl Atkinson obtained documents that haven't been seen by the public until now.
Early enrollment figures are contained in notes from twice-a-day war room meetings convened within the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services after the website failed on October 1st. They were turned over in response to a document request from the House Oversight Committee. The website launched on Tuesday. Publicly, the government said there were 4.7 million unique visits in the first 24 hours. But at a meeting Wednesday morning, the war room notes say six enrollments have occurred so far. They were with Blue Cross, Blue Shield, North Carolina and Kansas City, CareSource, and Healthcare Service Corporation. By Wednesday afternoon, enrollments were up to approximately 100. By the end of Wednesday, the notes reflect 248 enrollments nationwide. The healthcare exchanges need to average 39,000 enrollees a day to meet the goal of 7 million by March 1st. The war room notes give a glimpse into some of the reasons customers had problems. Direct enrollment, signing up directly on an insurer's website, is not working for any issuers. Experian Credit Reporting Agency is creating confusion with credit check information. Issuer phone numbers are not appearing correctly on the Pay Now page. The notes leave no doubt that the enrollment figures, which the administration has chosen to keep secret, are available. Statistics coming in, say notes from the very first meeting the morning of October 2nd, contractor QSSI has a daily dashboard created every night. But head of CMS Marilyn Taverner wouldn't disclose the figures when Dave Camp, chair of the House Ways and Means Committee, asked earlier this week.
I mean, how do you not know how many people have enrolled?
Chairman Camp, we will have those numbers available in mid-November.
Health and Human Services today told us it's in no position to confirm or discuss enrollment figures because it doesn't have any. A spokesman suggested that enrollment was always expected to start very slowly and then skyrocket as the deadline approaches, Scott.
Cheryl Atkinson breaking the news tonight, and we'll follow up tomorrow. Thank you, Cheryl.